It is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Welcome to the teaching ministry of Life Changing Ministries International with Dr. E.K.D. Quick. With your Bible in hand and your heart open to learn, let's join the teaching in progress.
From the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 14. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. We are continuing a series on who is the Holy Spirit. The goal of this teaching is to understand who the Holy Spirit is, His existence, and how to walk with Him. The Holy Spirit or Holy Ghost is the third person in the Godhead. He is eternal, always existing, and is the agent by which God may execute His divine plan. The Holy Spirit or Holy Ghost is the same word in the literal Greek, the word pneuma, which means to breathe. These words, Holy Spirit or Holy Ghost, are interchangeable in Scripture. This is the teaching on who is the Holy Spirit, part 2, point number 4. Who is, in particular, the Holy Spirit? This particular list that I am about to expound on is lettered A, B, C, etc. This list is not exhaustive. This list is more suggestive, for we cannot fully articulate or write down the inexhaustible attributes of the Holy Spirit. Point 4A, the Holy Spirit is a comforter. John chapter 14, verse 18 and verse 26, Jesus Christ prepares the disciples by giving them understanding that the Holy Spirit is a comforter. Jesus Christ is about to depart the earth as suffering for the sins of the world and rising from the dead, and they are given encouragement that they are not to be left alone, but to be given another comforter, another just like him, someone to comfort them in the time of their sorrow and persecution, and to give them joy and fulfillment along their journey as a Christian. John chapter 4, verse 16 states, and I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that ye may abide with you forever. This comforter, this Holy Spirit, is with us as believers 24 hours a day. We can have comfort in the time of our persecution, comfort in the times of going through persecution on our job, persecution in our home, comfort in going through health crises, financial crises, things that would cause others to begin to be depressed or anxious. We as Christians have the comfort and encouragement of the Holy Spirit to assure us that if God be for us, who can be against us? The Comforter, the Holy Spirit, will begin to encourage our hearts to continue and not give up and lose faith or lose heart. The Comforter will begin to encourage us that we can do all things through Christ Jesus, which strengthens us. The Comforter will begin to encourage us that we are more than conquerors through Him that loved us. Point 4B, the Holy Spirit is an enabler. Acts chapter 1, verse 8 says, But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Spirit is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost parts of the earth. This word in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, witnesses, is the Greek word martus, where we get our word martyr from. A martyr is a person that dies for the cause. What this scripture is teaching in that context is that we as witnesses have died to ourselves. We have died to the old man, and now the new man in Christ is alive. Individuals cannot expect to be witnesses for Jesus until they are witnesses unto Jesus. Individuals cannot expect to speak and be witnesses for Jesus until they become dead to themselves, witnesses or martyrs unto Jesus. And this enabling power by the Holy Spirit is not us that accomplishes great things in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, but it is the Holy Spirit empowering us and enabling us to do great exploits for the Lord. God gets the glory and God gets the praise, for it is the Holy Spirit that enables us to witness. It is the Holy Spirit that enables us to hand out tracts. It is the Holy Spirit that enables us to stand in the storm and in the fire of persecution and ridicule and still proclaim that Jesus is Lord. It is the enabling power of the Holy Spirit that causes us to go forward in Christ and accomplish His will. An example of enabling power can also be seen in Exodus chapter 31, as individuals were given a task to build the altar and all the artifacts that are contained in the temple and coincide with the altar. Scripture teaches that these individuals were anointed and the Spirit of God will empower them to create the artifacts of God. Not their skill and not their talent, but the Holy Spirit enabling them to do so. This is our charter and our cause, that the Holy Spirit is empowering us to live holy and live righteous, to stand in the fire, to not give up, to overcome persecution and circumstances. It is not ourselves, but the enabling power of the Holy Spirit by the grace of God. Scripture teaches, I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. It is the power, the enabling power of the Holy Spirit that causes us to go forward in Christ Jesus. Point 4C. The Holy Spirit is a gift giver. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, a listing of the gifts of the Spirit. These gifts of the Spirit are not based on personal talent. These gifts of the Spirit are not based on acquired skills. These gifts of the Spirit are not based on individuals beginning to model certain characteristics after others and following in their path. These gifts of the Spirit are enabled, are empowered, are led, are given by the Holy Spirit. These gifts of the Spirit are authenticated because if they are real from the Lord, they will produce fruit of the Spirit. if they are of man in terms of just acquired talents or just acquired skills, then they will not produce the fruit of the Spirit. They will not produce a life-changing event in the person's life. They will not transform from sickness to health. They will not transform from darkness to light. They will not transform from sadness to joy. They will not transform into the works of the Lord, giving the results of the Lord. These gifts of the Spirit are only driven by the Holy Spirit. Without the Holy Spirit, they are mere talents, mere acquired skills that have been acquired by man to look like the gifts of the Spirit. Instead, true gifts of the Spirit give real and true results that are life-changing and transformational and give God the glory and line up with Scripture. Point 4D. The Holy Spirit is a salvation agent. John chapter 3, the words of our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus said, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Jesus Christ said, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. The Holy Spirit is the salvation agent that changes an individual's heart. When an individual, by faith, receives Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, when an individual, by faith, admits that they are sinners, lost, and through love, loving, trusting faith, accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, they are born again. The Spirit of God comes on the inside and amalgamates itself with our dead spirit and quickens us and makes us alive to God and dead to sin. Titus chapter 3, verse number 5 says, not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy, he saved us by the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost. This salvation agent, the Holy Spirit, regenerates us, renews us in the Lord. Salvation is not rehabilitation. Salvation is regeneration. Scripture teaches, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things have become new. The regenerating power of the Holy Spirit. This is why we learned earlier on the existence of the Holy Spirit, that from 1 Thessalonians 5:23, we have a spirit, a soul, and a body. The Holy Spirit, through salvation, regenerates our dead spirit, as spoken of in Ephesians chapter 2 through 4. Point number 4E. The Holy Spirit is a reprover or a convictor. John chapter 16, verse number 8. And when he is come, he will reprove or convict the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment. The Holy Spirit is operating throughout the earth, convicting and pricking and tugging at the hearts of men. God gave all individuals a conscience, and this conscience is the moral barometer of our being. And the Holy Spirit works to convict our conscience of godly rights and wrongs, and causes individuals to be convicted in their heart that they are lost and in need of a Savior. The Holy Spirit, the loving Holy Spirit, is convicting and pulling and tugging in the midnight hour, in the noonday, and through all different kinds of avenues, God is trying to get the attention of individuals through the conviction of the Holy Spirit. God is using a track. God is using a sermon. God is using the lives of others. God is using every mechanism known and unknown to use the Holy Spirit to convict the hearts of individuals to bow their knee and accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Scripture teaches in Hebrews chapter 3, "Wherefore, as the Holy Ghost speaketh, harden not your heart." So when the Holy Spirit is tugging and convicting and wooing individuals, individuals should respond and bow their knee and accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. And for those that have strayed away who are believers, the Holy Spirit is convicting individuals to repent and rededicate their life to Christ. Point 4F, the Holy Spirit is a teacher. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse number 10 and verse number 14. "But God has revealed them unto us by His Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things, yea, the deep things of God. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him, neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned." Without the Holy Spirit, we are unable to receive and understand the things of God. Without the Holy Spirit, we cannot understand the Scriptures. Without the Holy Spirit, we cannot understand the plan of God for our life. Without the Holy Spirit, we cannot understand the love of God, the mercy of God, the grace of God. Without the enlightenment and the illumination of the Holy Spirit, the things of God are not understood and received by intellect. The things of God are not received and understood by education. The things of God are not received and understood by experience. The things of God are only received and understood by the precious Holy Spirit that takes our finite mind and gives spiritual understanding to the spiritual things of God. Individuals without the Holy Spirit, unbelievers without the Holy Spirit, cannot understand nor receive the things of God. This is the teaching on who is the Holy Spirit, part 2. And on today, if you do not know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, or if you have strayed away from His loving kindness, I invite you to pray this prayer with me. This prayer of salvation, this prayer of rededication. Oh God, I am a sinner. I believe that Jesus Christ died for my sins. I believe that God raised Him from the dead. Come into my heart. Come into my life. Save me today. Forgive me, I pray. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Thank you for listening to the teaching ministry of Life Changing Ministries International. LCMI is a Christian non-denominational teaching ministry based solely on the Holy Bible, dedicated to pleasing God, glorifying Jesus Christ, and ensuring that the Bible is the foundation in everything this ministry proclaims and endorses. For more information, log on to our website at lifechangingministries.com. Please join us again next time for more Bible teaching. And remember, we have the victory through Jesus Christ.